Greetings, everyone. My name is Bob Lynn. I'm a retired union organizer with the Plumbers and Pipe-fitters and did that for my career. What I want to talk to you tonight about, or today actually about, is labor and how it fits in with the National Infrastructure Bank. It's very important to understand why we need a National Infrastructure Bank. Currently, the way all financing is done when it comes to infrastructure is it's done through pay-as-you-go on the federal level. That means dollars have to be allocated in order to be able to be spent on the highway system, on water infrastructure, on electrical, et cetera. The big challenge has been, how do you pay for infrastructure? If you ask anybody, they always say, infrastructure is very important, but I don't want to raise taxes. I don't want to increase any of that cost, et cetera. And currently, the way we're going through it right now, our deficit has gotten to be unbelievably high. And people will say, we can't afford to do it. I'm telling you right now, we can't afford not to do it. At the end of the day, infrastructure will be the way out of the recession that we're probably, the recession we're in and possible depression that could be coming. The only way we will ever get out of the debt situation that we're in is we actually have to grow out of it. That's how it's happened every other time that we've ever had it. When you start the Revolutionary War, we were in huge debt. We had to grow out of it. The last time it was used, we were in the Great Depression. We had to grow out of our debt. We had to be able to grow the economy. We had to be able to increase the productivity of this country to make it happen. If you go around and look at a number of the other videos that are available on this website, you'll see that Ofek and Mutardi talks about the structure of the bank, and Stan Forzek, he goes and talks about rail, all important aspects. But one of the things that's really important here is to understand that the $4 trillion bank we're talking about at the end of the day is how to pay for the infrastructure, period. That's what we have to do, is be able to pay for the infrastructure. And right now, with the way Congress is, the way the country is, 50-50, where we continue to fight about everything instead of trying to figure out how we as Americans can actually get back to work. The best social welfare program there is, it's called a job. And people will need to get back to work, and they are looking to get back to work. They are not, we are not freeloaders as a society. We continue to want to be able to produce things and have a real impact on things. Companies, manufacturing, they chose to leave this country years ago and go to China because it was cheaper. We need them to come back, and the best way to get them to come back is by making sure that we have what they want. And what does a company want when it moves into a community? They want education, an educational system. They want a quality workforce, and the other thing they need is infrastructure. And infrastructure is the missing link when it comes to it, to be able to have the infrastructure to be able to move freight, to be able to move people, to be able to communicate, to be able to have broadband, to be able to have all those expansive ideas out there. You need to have the investment to be able to do that. Infrastructure and the $4 trillion bank that we're proposing at the end of the day really is about making sure that we create jobs. $4 trillion will create, it's estimated, at least 25 million jobs. And these jobs will be building trades workers to build the thing, to be able to build the actual infrastructure. It will be architects, engineers, material handlers, truckers. In addition, after that money goes in specifically for the infrastructure, and once it's built, and for trains and all the rest of this stuff, guess what? Manufacturing will start to move in to be able to do it. And every dollar that's spent in the community turns over from 3 to 7 times once it's invested in there. So that starts to get the economy to boom. Once we have that kind of investment in a community, once we start to address all the things that are going on the whether it's hurricane and flood possibilities that could be happening with climate change, or with hurricanes, et cetera, or we look at being able to get fresh water to people. Desalination projects could explode to be able to actually get water to communities that need it to be able to do that. Innovation comes when people have the ability and have money to be able to invest in it. Right now, with our service-based economy and the small wages that we are paying people, at the end of the day, is not enough to inspire people to be able to go out and be able to use their imagination, be able to fix things. This kind of investment in America will inspire that kind of infrastructure, and that's what's important to remember. One more thing that I want to emphasize here is jobs will be entry level through journeyman, through master, to be able to make sure that you get somebody started so they learn how to be able to do the work that's necessary. They'll get the training, the hands-on training that's necessary to be able to make these jobs happen. And we'll give them an opportunity to really make a living and be able to retire one day, hopefully with some dignity. The pay that we're talking about in the bill, and let me back up a second. The bill, you need to know what the bill is. H.R. 6422 was introduced on March 31st by Representatives Danny Davis of Illinois and Seth Moulton of Massachusetts. The bill basically establishes a private bank owned wholly by the United States government and backed by it. But it is designed to focus on infrastructure. The projects that will get addressed are projects that are necessary and needed in these communities. It shouldn't matter if your congresswoman or person in Congress or your senator is powerful or not. What should matter is whether or not you get the money necessary in your community to be able to make it, to be able to make whatever needs to get done, address that and get it fixed. And that's what this bank is talking about, it making sure that we have that kind of investment to be able to do it. And so it's important as we look at this to understand the importance of establishing the bank. Again, if you need the details on a bank, make sure you flip over to Alfeca's talk about it. She explains it very well. What I'm here to tell you is that this is something that we all need. And the way to make it happen is by you, every one of you, taking the time to reach out to your congressperson or your senator or even your city council, even your county executives, to be able to get them to understand the importance of investing in our future. Infrastructure is the answer to our problems at the end of the day. If we have a good infrastructure, we can build, and once we build something, then people will come, as they say, to be able to make things happen. So, again, what I will tell you, the only way we will ever get a bill passed is people, like yourselves, have to say, who do I know? Who can I contact? Who can I reach out to? I am a member of several different organizations, and I'm sure each one of you is too. What I ask you is take this proposal to that group. Get them to endorse it. Get them to understand the importance of it. Because at the end of the day, this is how things work in the world. A small group of people go get things started, and once they get it started and they build the parade, I guarantee you the politicians and leaders always come to the front and are willing to take it across the finish line. We have to be able to make this happen, and you have that power. So I encourage you, contact your congressperson, contact your senator, ask them, do they know about H.R. 6422? Follow all the other, there's information throughout this whole website, and there'll be, after this video, to be tagged on where you can go to get more information. Educate yourself, figure out what's important and why this needs to happen and what you can do about it. Because at the end of the day, you are the most important person that can make this happen. I will do my part, you do your part, ask 10 people that you know to do their part. Next thing you know, this thing explodes and continues to be able to be the answer. Because the one thing that I fear is where we currently are, things are going to turn, I believe, for the worse as far as manufacturing and as far as jobs, et cetera. Because at the end of the day, we have been pumping a tremendous amount of money in to keep the system is where the system where it is at the moment. But we need to understand that when the bottom falls out and jobs are needed, because right now they estimate that we have 40 million people unemployed. Think about that, 40 million people. So how do we make this happen? Brothers and sisters, I'm going to tell you right now, as a fellow American, I'm asking you, let's take the politicians out of this equation. Let's make this infrastructure bank to go and address projects on an as-needed basis so that the projects get built the way they're supposed to. And let's empower ourselves to be able to make this happen. Thank you very much for watching this. And please explore the website. Look for a few more other things. And if you have any questions, you have any suggestions, any thoughts, please don't hesitate to reach out to us so that, one, you can get the answers you need. And two, if you need something else, or we need to know something, we're learning every day. Thank you.